Hi, I'm Analytical, the sickeningly entertaining and educational coding queen, and today we are going to do a little makeover for the terminal. Oh, we're going to turn this into this. The terminal, command prompt, command line, it can be called a lot of those things, the shell. It's honestly so scary the first time you encounter it, the first time you see someone using it, you think, oh my God. That genius, they know what they're doing. They're smart. They're a coder. They're a hacker. And none of that is true. Well, maybe a little bit of it's true, especially if it's me that you're seeing doing it. But I don't want you to be scared of it because there are so many important things you're going to be able to learn as an engineer, as a programmer, while you're trying to represent yourself in tech by building lots of technology. You're going to need to use the terminal. And if you're scared of it, then that's not going to work. So we're going to glam it up. We're going to change the colors. We're going to change the names. We're going to make it really pretty. If you're excited about that, leave a like on the video, comment, subscribe, and ring that bell to make sure I feel your love. Thank you. So if you've ever opened the terminal on Mac, there is the terminal app. I also use iTerm. And when you first open it, you might get something that's black with a green text on it. You might just be black and white. There's a lot of black and green. Sometimes it might just be black and white. And this is also called command prompt on Windows if you're trying to follow along. So this is totally no fun. We've got my other name. Ugh! We've got this ugly text. It's just, I'm not excited, uninterested. So we're gonna have to make it fun. I think the first thing we should try to do is change this name, because a lot of times I think with queer people, you might see the name that you were given or just another name you use, and that's not the one you want to be coding with. I'm going to be using iTerm2 for this, and you feel free to use that on Mac. It's totally free. I just like it. It has a few extra features beyond the regular terminal, but if you want to use regular terminal, you can't download it. Totally fine to follow along. So this text that's coming up here is stored in a variable called PS1. Don't worry if you don't know about variables. They're just the same as in math. And if we Google like PS1 generator, I've already pulled up a few. There are a ton of these. I like this EZprompt. They're all kind of ugly web pages. There's this one also, but I'm going to use EZprompt just because I think it's a little bit easier. Right now, we can actually type echo $PS1, all caps, not the one, to see what this variable is. So we've got a slash H, we've got slash capital W, slash lowercase u, and then a dollar sign. I really don't know what any of this means, but I can kind of infer based on what we have here. So the dollar sign is the dollar sign, slash u is the user, w is, I think this is our current directory, and then this is the name of my machine. We kind of just want the working directory, that's w, and we can actually find that here. So current directory, we can click that, and then we're gonna get that in. So that's, again, W. Let me zoom in here for you all. So we've got current directory, and that's gonna be W. And then there are a ton of different things we can throw in here. We could throw the username, but we definitely don't want that anymore. And it's a little bit repetitive to use. And we don't need the shell version, any status elements. Git status could be really useful. If you're a little more advanced and wanna throw that in, go for it. Date and time could be useful to see how long ago something was, how long something took. I'm gonna use some extra characters. Let's throw a space in here and let's do some custom emojis. I'm gonna go up here to find the emojis and symbols. I guess I can use Control Command Space to pull that up too. And I want the coding lady. Where'd she go? I have to pull that up again. I want the coding lady. Maybe I'll just drag it in, and then the queen, because I am the coding queen. And we can just click plus to add that in. And now this is what our output's gonna be. I think it's nice that we have another space before everything else that's gonna come there. And then all we have to do is click export PS1. We just copy and paste that in. And we can see this is our new command. And already, and I'm gonna do command K just to clear this out, or you can, I think, right click and do clear. So we're already off to a really good start. I already feel great. We've got a lot more room on the screen. We've got the coder and the queen. Everything I'm living for. Then we're gonna go into preferences to change these colors around, because these are not working for me. So preferences, and you're going to go to profiles. So we're in the default profile right now, and you can choose some general settings, like where you're going to start working. The colors. Yes, we're going to play with the colors. Text, you can change the font size, some window stuff. All right, let's just dive in. I'm going to duplicate this. So I'm just hopping into the colors. There are actually a ton of really good presets you can use. If you change these around, you'll see the colors change, but you won't. It's not going to change in here right now. So what we're going to need to do is, can I change it like this? I'll do demo colors. And again, you'll notice this is still the old one. So we're going to have to copy and paste that command in again. But don't worry, in a few minutes in this video, I will show you how to make it persist constantly so you don't have to copy and paste it in all the time. But just to get started with the basics, we want to not be bogged down by all of that. Go back to preferences, you can do command comma. And here are some of the preferences. So there's a pastel version. We can't really see a ton of these. Let me run a few commands so we can see some more of the colors. LS, AL, FG. I know what some of this does, but I'm really just making up some of it too. Solarize Dark. I actually really like to use this one on my personal computer because I think it's just really easy to work with. Solarize Light, Tango Dark, Tango Light. A ton of different options, and you're gonna wanna pick one that's gonna work well for your eyes. You don't want your eyes to be strained if you're looking at your computer a lot. One thing I really like about iTerm is there are all these color schemes you can download that people have created. I think they're really cool, but I think for most terminal applications, you'll be able to find custom colorations like this as well. So don't feel like, oh, you have to use iTerm to get these colors. We're gonna do our own, so let's start with Solarize Dark. I definitely prefer a dark screen because I feel like I'm working a lot at night. I just don't want my eyes to be strained as much. And let's set this background. You all know I love purple. I already built, if you see up here, I have built a purple one of these already. So maybe let's play with a different color scheme so you can just see what's up. Let's do like an orange background because it kind of matches my hair. I'm really mixing things up today. I still want this to be dark. Okay. It's like rusty, but not brown. You know, we're going to go with pink because that it's like, I don't want like a, ooh, coral. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. But maybe a little darker. Ooh, like a deep maroon coral. Is foreground is going to be our text color. So I think you kind of want something light if you're doing a darker, theme. Okay. That's like starting to be easy to read on the eyes. Selected text, maybe let's make this like this really cute blue. So now we can select text. Wow, we're really getting nice colors. It just changes the color of the selected text, doesn't change the selection. So you can set that to pink and then this to be like the blue. Ooh, we're really getting fun with these. So you can change these around as much as you want. And then in here are ANSI colors. ANSI's in your pansies colors. When we run the command like ls, which lists all the folders in this directory, some of them are assigned certain colors. So they might be assigned red, green, yellow, all those colors there, you know how to read. But when you choose a theme, basically the theme will reroute some of those colors. So here we have like this blue thing. So if we change this, anything that's supposed to be blue will instead become pink or orange or whatever color we set it to. I honestly have not seen a lot of these colors in action. So whatever you see, I think you could change the blue is a good one to change, the black maybe. I don't know, you can really play around with this constantly as you're working with it. And one thing to think about is in here, when we were creating our easy prompt, you can set these colors. So if you click on it and click foreground, you could set it to be the magenta. If we copy this in, I'm gonna change the background to be magenta so it's a little easier to see. I'll have to make this really big. So instead of being magenta, or this is basically what magenta is getting colored to. So it doesn't matter if it is assigned magenta. When you have your theme selected, it will choose whatever color is specified instead. So those are a few options. I like to make the text big because my eyes, ugh, I like can't even see anymore. So maybe I'll do like 36 and then choose like a much better font than whatever they started you out with. I really like Roboto. I feel like that's a very trendy, chic, elegant font. So I'd go for it. And I would say stick to a monospaced font. And a monospaced font, it just means every character is the same width. So
every line in here is going to have the exact same amount of characters. In some fonts, maybe the O is a little bit wider, maybe the P is a little bit smaller. All the sizes vary a little bit. So those are some of those settings. What else can we do in here? You can change the cursor. So instead of having a box, you'll have a vertical bar. You can have a blink. That's not that exciting. I think this final step that's exciting is transparency. Transparency is okay because it's hard to see, but when you add the blur, you really get some cool effects here. So you can see part of the background of what you have behind it, but it still feels like, oh, you're focused on the main thing, which is your terminal. And you could set a background image if you want, but I think that might just be a little too distracting. This is how you can play around with the colors in Terminal and choose whichever ones are going to make you happy and make your eyes feel really good. So let me open up my purple one that I've created in advance. Purple. So I have some nice purple font. Let me do this LSALFG. Honestly, we're just playing around. I've got some cool colors. When I highlight the links, they're purple. But again, we still have this pesky name. So what we're going to have to do, let me close this out. So what we're going to have to do is create a configuration file. We're actually going to need to make two because we're on Mac. On Windows and Linux, I don't think you'll need to create two, but I would look it up. But it should be pretty similar to what we're doing here. And we're going to need to do this in a text editor. On Mac, there is TextEdit built in, but I think using Sublime, which is a totally free tool, will be a little easier. And it's a really popular text editor for Mac. And I think it actually is on Windows too. The first file we're going to make is called bashrc. So we're going to save this as .bashrc in the analytical home directory or your user home directory, you'll know, because it has the home icon. And this is one of the files for the bash configuration. And yes, we'll use a name that starts with a dot, even though it's reserved for the system because we are programmers. And today we are pro-glammers. Here, we're going to copy our command from the easy bash prompt. Let's not choose the one with purple. I already had it written out. Here, actually, I want to add a space at the end again. Written out. And we're just going to throw this in here in our bashrc. And then, what else are we going to do? There are a few things we're going to throw in here also. These are just a few configurations when you're doing ls, which is the list files command, the list directories command. It'll add a lot of colors to them just easily, and you don't have to think about it as much. So we're going to add an alias in here for ls. So instead of just giving us the plain list files command, we're going to say alias l. Let's actually just do ls. So every time you run ls, let's get all the colors because it'll just look so much prettier and it'll be so much nicer to use. So now we'll save this. And if you're on a Mac, you're also going to need to use a bash profile. It's a little annoying, but you won't have to think about it after this video. I'm going to search bash profile Mac include bashrc. I'm going to easily be able to find this command, but I'll link it below for you, so don't worry. And this is basically saying, if there's a bashrc file, include it, bring it into this terminal window, and take all those commands for it. So we'll close these out. We'll close out Sublime, and I'll actually include those files in the description below. So if you need them, you'll be able to copy and paste them in. And now nothing's changed yet, but when we open a new window, we get exactly how we want to be represented on this computer as the coding queen in the purple glamour, in the big font. And I love it. I want to see screenshots of your customized terminals. It's so easy to do this, and I actually haven't spent a ton of time getting familiar with how to customize terminal. And I'm actually so much happier that now when I log on, I get to see a gorgeous purple terminal that makes me feel like the sickening drag queen I am. There are a ton of articles and blogs. I'll include some of the ones I used for this video below to make it more customized, to make more colors appear when you do list files and list all those commands. But for now, I think this is a great starting point. If you like this video, leave a like on it, subscribe, ring the bell to make sure you don't miss any more of my coding content. I really like getting to play around with the terminal. I think this is something that can be really intimidating. So if we can learn it together, then it'll just make it so much more fun and so much more entertaining for all of us. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!